Hello, today in this video we'll be doing a quick tutorial for the Shotcut editing software. It's free yet professional and still very simple for beginners to learn. So in this video we'll be going through everything you need, even if you've never heard of that software before. We're going from download down to the place where we'll export our finished video. So the first thing here is to open your browser and simply search for Shotcut, s-h-o-t-c-u-t, and they go to shotcut.org. So it's an open source software and it's free, and you simply click to download. So based on what you are using, whether Windows or Mac or Linux, so I'll just choose one of these Windows installers here. As you can see, it's downloading here. So when it's done downloading, just simply double click it or go look for it where you downloaded it in your downloads. And I just double click this and I agree. Next, I want to create a desktop Shotcut and I simply click install. So it is done installing. So I just look for the icon on my desktop, and note this works for only desktop. For your smartphone you can use InShot, it's a free app, but for Shotcut it works for just your PC, your laptop. So I open Shotcut and this is the interface you will see when you just get started. Don't be overwhelmed with all of this. This place here, it says new project and recent project. If you have previous projects, they will show here. So let's just say for this new project, let me just say Vidpride. Just leave every other thing here, and note that for this tutorial, as much as possible I'll try to be very simple. There's advanced editing, but that will be beyond the scope of this video. I might do a separate video for that. So with that, you just leave it as automatic and just click start. You see a lot of things here, but just note these few things. First, here you have like a menu bar where different things are, like if you want to undo something, you want to save, you want to open a new file, you want to adjust the timeline and stuff like that. Second, this box here is where you have a preview, meaning that if you bring in any file, maybe audio, video, and images, here is where you see it, you preview it. The lower portion here is the timeline. Don't worry, you understand this as we move on. Let me just remove some of these things. And I note that if you check this part, you see X here, you see X here, you see X here, meaning that you can close these things. For example, if I just click on this X, this it has closed. The first step is to import our video files. Here you can click open file to import a single file. If you want to import multiple files and folders, meaning that maybe you have different video clips and different audio stuff, you can just use playlist. So let me just use open file for now. So this is an edited file, but then yours will be raw and unedited. I'm just using this as a sample for you to understand. So if you have done this, you can just simply drag this to your timeline. The beauty of this thing is that you can adjust this timeline the way you want, and I can use this to zoom in and zoom out, or I'll simply drag this slider to zoom in and zoom out. If I want it to be maximum, I just can click this and it will fit the timeline to my screen. It's as simple as cutting out your mistakes. So the first step is to import your clip. So let's assume you are getting this from your camera, maybe your smartphone. You bring it to your laptop and then you drag it. You use open file to get to the file that you need, and then you drag it. You can simply drag it to your timeline. Now let's go on to cutting out the mistakes. You know, you have to make your videos fast paced, so you cut out every mistakes, every second guessing, every ums, every ahs, every dead end, every space, everything. With this I can simply drag slider wherever I want to cut or work on, bring it to where I want, and I click S. So you see it has split. I can simply select this and listen, shift delete, shift plus delete, and it's gone. It will snap back into position. If I want to do that for the end, I simply drag my slider to the end, then click S, and then select where I want to delete and do shift delete. That's all. If it's in the middle, maybe I made a mistake somewhere, I simply drag this other slider so that I will know where I made the mistake. I'll play it using this waveform to guide me. Counselor and an evangelist. Okay, so maybe I want to remove where I said evangelist. So I bring my slider to this point, click S, then play evangelist. This is where evangelist ends. So I simply put it there and click S again, and I click where I want to delete and control delete or control backspace. So you go through your raw footage, removing all the silence, every mistake, every second guessing, every dead end, every arms, everything. The next thing now is to add things. Let's start with the first one, which is text. When you want to add things, there's what we call filter here. For this filter, if you click plus, but you have to select what you want to add those things to. If, for example, I want to say, hello, my name is Dr. Malik, and I said it, and you can drag. If you want to move around, you can drag this. I want to put my name here. I just simply come in here, put the place where I want to put the name, and click S to split it where I want the name to disappear, and I click S again, and I'll select that place. We're not deleting now, and I'll go to filter. I simply click plus. There's what we call favorite here. So you have all the favorite and common things people use here. So I simply go to text and click on text. Type out what I want to type. If I double click this, I'll have the opportunity, you see this, to type my texts. This is the text box. Don't worry, it might be different depending on what you are using, right? Don't worry, just play around. So let me just type Dr. Malik Aruna King. Now the beauty of this is if you click and hold on the middle, you can move it around to where you want, and then these handles are adjustable. You can drag them, you can drag it this way, they are all adjustable. So, and then with this you can just move it to where you want, and you can see this editor here. I can reduce the size, I can reduce, you know, just play around and see what you can do. So this entire thing, I want it to reduce to 40, or let's just say 30. Let me just increase this to 40, and then I just adjust this. Apart from that, there are different things. I can make it bold, I can remove it, I can italicize, just the normal editing you can do. Then you can change the font type to whatever you want. You can even add background color. You can go ahead and put the background color. You can see if I click away, okay, yeah, sorry, I said background color instead of font color. That's font color. If you want to change background color, come here, you see background color, you can change it. Apart from working on this menu here, you can do a lot here. You can even choose the way it comes in. Now this is the same way if you want to put the title of the video. Maybe you want to say buy land in Lagos. You can simply just come in here and do the same thing. Let me just remove this background color. I can just simply drag this to be able to see it and just click on this. Go back to what I want. Come here and centralize it since the title, drag it to the point I want. If I click away, I'll be able to see it neatly, right? If I don't like the color, I can change it. So for your lower thirds, titles for the different section, maybe you're saying number one this, number two this, and you want the text to show, you can do all of that by adding the text. So let's move on to the next thing, and that will be adding b-rolls. Maybe I want to add another video on top of this. So I simply go to open file and look for the video. So let me import the video. This is it. Now if I don't want the entire video to show, I can simply just come in here and drag the handle, right? See, I drag the handle, drag this handle to where I want. Let me just split now from here to here. I want to stop here, so I just drag the handle there. You won't just bring it. If you bring it here now, it will just replace what you have. You see, overwrite, you won't do that. You simply come in to this place, to this hamburger icon here, come to track operation and say add video track, add video track, and click this. You see a video track has been added. If I bring this here, you see it just changes, it changes immediately, it changes. I can drag this upwards and drag it downwards. Now that I have this here, I can simply hold this and drag to where I want. Maybe here I'm talking about a preacher. Just test it and see. Select here. You remember how we did it before? Make sure it is selected. The one you want to edit is selected, and I click S, right? And it has split it, and I just select where I don't want, and I click delete. That's how to add b-rolls. If you have images, this is the same way you do it. Let's say you want to add a like button or subscribe button, is still the same thing. Again, I go to my open file and locate it. So we have an animated subscribe button here. I simply click and open to look at it there. So I simply just hold it, drag, and if I want it to be here, I just click it here. So
all right,
and make sure my slider is there. I come to filter and I come to position, size and position, and make sure that it is selected here. Come to size and position, you see this handle will show, so I can simply hold it and drag the way I want, right? Because that's quite large. Maybe I just want it to appear, then I just hold this middle and drag it to where I want. So it's still selected. If I select somewhere else, you see.
All right,
so that's where you do for your like button, for your subscribe button, and different kind of things. If what you have has a background, a green screen, let me just show you an example. So I come come back to my open file again. I have this green screen like button. Look at it. So I don't want this green to be there. Remember, I make sure this track is selected. I simply drag it to where I want to put the like button. It will say overwrite because there's nothing there. So what I will do is I'll click the same way again. You know, I told you filter is where you make any changes you want to make. So I just simply click there, go to filters, and then I'll look for chroma key. Let me just use a simple. You see, it has removed it. And you see, I'll just drag this to adjust it. And I'm good to go. And this software is free and it's not heavy on your computer. If you have an end screen, you still do the same thing. You want to put an end screen at the end of your video. So you see this one, end screen. I click and look at the end screen. So I just simply drag and put where I want to put the main thing. When I click, and then it shows at the end. So you put your end screen while editing, then you put in the videos you want there while uploading. You put your end screen while editing and you put those videos you want to show here while uploading on YouTube. For example, if your clip is not too sharp and then you want to augment it a little, let me just drag this down so that we'll see. Maybe I want to adjust the color correction, color grading. I simply click it and again to filter, and then we come here and see color grading. Let me drag this a little. So notice this. If I drag this, can you see it's changing? It's changing, right? So you can adjust the shadows here. When you reach where you like, you just stop. You can adjust the highlights here. When you reach where you like it, you can just stop. Just come here, adjust. When you reach where you like, you stop. However, what I prefer for you to do is to click on the video and then come to filter as usual, then come to saturation. That's what I usually advise my students to work on. Just click on plus and look for saturation. For most of my students, this is what I just advise you to do. Just come in here and slide, see, to make it pop, make your skin clean small. Do you understand? So if you come here, when it just pops, that's all. That is all the editing I advise my students to do. And then when you are done, just click away. You can just remove this. And note that if you make any mistake, you can just simply click here and you undo it. You undo and redo here. And very importantly, you can just save. I advise my students to do the color correction before splitting, so that when you do the color correction, it will apply to all video. The entire video. Before you start splitting, before you start removing mistakes, the first thing you do is color grading and color correction, or just adjust the saturation as I advise. So the next thing here I want to do, maybe you have soundtrack you want to bring in, and again come into open file and locate it and bring in the soundtrack. Again, if you want the entire soundtrack, you can just drag and drop, or you can just use this where you want this other one to trim. But before you drag, you discover that there's no audio track here. So again, you come to this hamburger menu here, come to track operation, say add audio track. Just drag this up and audio track has been added. So I can now drag this audio to the audio session. Let me drag to the very beginning. Select this, go to filter again, and then add. Just type volume or see gain volume, click it, and then you can reduce it the way you want, right? Reduce it and then you listen. And then if it's too loud, you still reduce it. It should be barely audible. You have to use your ear, listen to what you are saying, and be sure that the background music is not louder than what you are saying, and then just make sure that it's barely perceptible. It's almost just barely audible. And still with this filter, there are several things you can do. Just play around, right? Audio, come to video. You see many things you can do with your videos, many to distort, many things. Come with audio, many things you can do with your audio. And so it's not just the favorite. Just come in here and look for and play around. So next we'll talk about export. So we've talked about how to import your video clip, do color correction, then split out, remove the mistakes, then add things like text, background music, like buttons, subscribe buttons, end screen, b-rolls, images, footages, sound effect, and so on. When you're done, click save and then go ahead and export. So you see export here, click here and leave it as custom. Where it says default, create this, just click and export your file. Choose the location and then you just simply export. Practice and play around. Just use 1 or 2 days, play around and get familiar with all of this. With this, you'll be able to do any kind of editing, even if it's just screen recording, even if it's animation, even if it's comedy, even if it's a talking head video like the one we just edited. You can do anything and everything, even complex editing processes like even using keyframes and so on. So if you find this video very helpful, hit the like button, stay subscribed, play big, and I'll see you in the next video.